End of days, son of Kumara, beloved Surya, 24 elders, receive now the ambassadors of the nations of the seed of Sanat Kumara at the court of the sacred fire. Beloved Helios and Vesta, receive them in thy home of light, and let these Telas, representing the divine plan of the nations on earth, representing the threefold flame of the power of culture, the power of education, the power of science, and the foundations of government, be now the dominion in our life, from the heart of God to the heart of man. We call upon the victory of the God flame. We call for the anointing of emissaries of light and those who are the light bearers in every nation this day. We now affirm with you, beloved Helios, the increase of that light, and by the power of our heart's flame, we do fan the flame of freedom in these nations. We demand they be cut free from the international capitalist communist conspiracy of the fallen ones and the machinations of the order and all other conspiracies known or unknown. We call upon the power of the Godhead to shatter the domination of the psychology, education, philosophy, and strategy of war, based on the philosophy of Hegel, of thesis, antithesis, and synthesis. We demand now the binding of the very cause and core of the entire lie of the serpent that has spawned the many movements right and left and east and west. Burn, who, O living word, consume the cause and core of the lie. Burn, who, we demand the action now. We raise now the mighty banner of Christ for and on behalf of the nations of the earth. We raise the mighty banner of freedom and the flame of Saint Germain. We call for the opening of the temple doors in the heart of Mother Mary, the doors to the heart of all light bearers in these nations. Let there be a mighty transfusion of freedom this day. Let there be the power of Almighty God that goes forth by our union, by our absolute God's determination to ignite the flame of freedom and send it round the world until the world is free, until we fulfill the desire of Helios and return 1 year hence for the fulfillment of that prophecy and for the laying of the next foundation of the next stair in the mighty spiral of our victory. In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, and the Mother, I am anointing now these souls of light to return as God's representative of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, and the Mother in their own towns and cities. Let them stand therefore in the flame of Saint Germain, and let them be empowered to transfer that word. I ask it, Almighty God, and I demand the defense of the Divine Mother in the person of Saraswati, Lakshmi, Durga, Kali, and the Mahakali, the White Goddess, beloved Kuan Yin, and Mother Mary, all ascended Lady Masters, the Goddess of Liberty, the Goddess of Life, the Queen of Life, the Goddess of Purity, beloved Nada, Pallas Athena, Portia, beloved Kuan Yin, the Great Divine Director, and beloved Cyclopea, please the full power of dispensation from the Karmic Board upon these souls of light and all who carry the banner for Saint Germain as the banners of their study groups and teaching centers and their own mandalas of light and their thought forms for the Elohim and Archangels and so on to the rays. Blaze a light too, blaze a light too, blaze a light too. In the name of Helios and Vesta, let the planet be transformed and let the unity of nations by the power of the sun begin here. And let that spiritual unity of nations be the symbol and the sign of the sun of Helios and Vesta for the building of the temple of victory in the heart of the inner retreat. We ask it and we demand it and we place it upon the altar of Saint Germain for the divine alchemy and on the altar of our own holy Christ self and beloved El Moria and beloved Anello for the adjudication of the will of God. In the name of Gautama Buddha, Lord Maitreya Jesus Christ, we salute Sanat Kumara. We salute Helios and Vesta. We salute Alpha and Omega. And we say, Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. I am thy kingdom come. I am thy will being done. I am on earth even as I am in heaven. I am giving this day daily bread to all. I am forgiving all like this day, even as I am also all like forgiving me. I am delivering all men from every evil condition. I am the kingdom, I am the power, and I am the glory of God in eternal immortal manifestation. All this I am.
The great divine director will speak to us now.
Friends of the great white brotherhood, friends of the culture of the motherland, I cannot keep silent, but must add my praise and support as spokesman this hour for the Great White Brotherhood in the affirmation and acceptance of the very presence and challenge, the mandates and the divine direction of beloved Helios. And therefore we gather, as we have also met in council this day in Darjeeling, and we, the Ascended Masters, pledge to you and to Helios and Vesta and to these representatives of the Father, Mother, God, as they are sent by Alpha and Omega to intensify, to enhance, and to release the full momentum of our light for the implementation of the will of God through beloved Helios and Vesta and the student body on earth. Therefore, beloved ones, from my own causal body of life, I intensify your action for the freeing of the nations and the flame of freedom from my own son, Saint Germain, is intensified and augmented not alone by my heart, but by all ascended masters and beings of light and hosts of the Lord serving these systems of worlds. For we have listened with great attentiveness both to the word of Helios and to the response of your heart. And we see the power of the oneness and the determination of that union. And therefore we tell you that here below we support every single act of your own which is intended to fulfill the will of Helios. And we send our legions and appoint them and establish now barriers of freedom around the nations. And we particularly desire the dissemination of the information of the fallen ones to the various organs of that which has been called the Order. Their plot to create the one world government. We are determined that you shall understand that plot fully and thoroughly, and that you shall oppose it with all of your might and your decrees, and also by illumination and education and the spreading abroad of the teachings. For the establishment of a one-world economy and a one-world government is the greatest threat to freedom on the planetary body as pertains to the geopolitical configurations in this hour. Beloved ones, therefore, we appeal to you to see that the advancing of the Soviet Union, the pacifism and indecision on the part of the United States, and many other factors on Earth make it necessary for the intensification of the light and the power of freedom. And you will note that I use that word intensification many times over, for you have a power in your heart that is the power of love. To increase the seed of light which Helios has placed there today, you have received an increment of fire, and that increment of fire does flow from the power of the ruby ray in the focus that has been used to transmit it. And thus the ruby ray can be for the acceleration, the deepening, and the purification of all of the light flowing to your chakras. Understand the meaning and the path of the ruby ray, for it is truly the open door by love to the action of the Holy Spirit, to the power of heaven and the power of earth as resident there through the mother of the world. Realize then that as we have been determined, yet our God determination is enlivened by a hope and a faith and a tremendous charity this night as we perceive your heart. And we realize that with this fervor and response to Almighty God, there can indeed be in this year a multiplication of the chelas of the sacred fire in all of the nations. And there can be a turning back and a turning around. And this is our present calculation as we calculate by the stars and by the chelas and by the weight of karma in the earth and so many factors that come into play. Beloved ones, there is a present reality for an uplift on the planet. There is the reality for the movement and the consuming of darkness. We see it, for we have beheld the light of the sun, Helios, and the light of the sons and daughters of God. Therefore, with one acclaim, the ascended masters of the Darjeeling Council, the Indian Council, the councils of the Royal Teton and of Lake Titicaca, join me now in a grand bravo for Helios. Bravo for the chelas of El Moria and Saint Germain. We are standing with you near as never before, for this devotion of this body worldwide is also at its peak as never before. And that devotion then becomes the magnet in the earth. And I tell you, all miracles are possible, and I adjure you to make use of the hours and moments here, for truly this land is electric, electrified by that great central sun magnet and other manifestations beneath the surface of the earth which are not as yet known to you. Beloved ones of the sun, it is no accident that the mount was named Electric Peak or that the river was named Yellowstone. Therefore, go to and find the condensed light of God in the earth and understand that through Old Faithful and the Grand Teton, you have foci of light so ancient that you can indeed convey to a planetary body the momentum of freedom. Let your decrees and mantras charge the earth with violet flame, charge the earth with purity and the ruby ray, charge the earth with the power of the legions of the cosmic cross of white fire and the ruby way, for the legions of victory are at hand, and they march. And you now attend the coming of mighty victory to this conference. I bid you a good evening and rejoicing in the flame of the God of freedom to the earth, Saint Germain. I am the great divine director. I bring greetings and love from all ascended hosts. O mighty light rays from the heart of God in the great central sun, beloved mighty I Am Presence, beloved Holy Christ Self of each and every one, we implore thy light to descend in the hearts of all people on earth. We call for thy light to inspire, to elevate, to accelerate now, to purge and cleanse the mind, the heart, and the soul, that each one might rise to fulfill the divine purpose of his incarnation on earth. I call to the mighty holy angels of our God. I call unto the great central sun. Clear now the life waves of this planetary home. Awaken within them the divine memory of the Ancient of Days and of their pre-existence and of their purpose for taking an embodiment in this life, in this century. We call to the seven mighty archangels and hosts of the Lord. We call unto the legions of light. Beloved Archangel Uriel, come forth. Blaze the full power of your Archangel Uriel this day. Blaze the power of Uriel, Archangel of the Judgment, Archangel now of the instrumentation of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Beloved Archangel Uriel, come forth now in the victory of the God flame. Clear now our four lower bodies. Let the purging light descend. Make us instruments now in every walk of life for the liberation of a planet and the people of all forms of slavery, known or unknown, within or without, self-imposed or imposed from other sources. We call to the victory of the light of God that never fails, for the turning of worlds, for the awakening of mankind to the hour of that victory of the soul in triumph over all things. Let us now, therefore, in the name of Mother Mary, invoke her power to put all things beneath our feet which are not good and of God and of holy purpose and of benefit to all people and all life everywhere. We demand the conquering of all that is less than our individual and personal reality and Christhood. We ask it in the name of the Universal Mother. Beloved Uriel, come forth now in the victory of the light. Amen. Let us sing to Archangel Uriel. Song number 304.
Lord Michael, me for, Lord Michael, behind, Lord Michael to the right, Lord Michael to the left, Lord Michael above, Lord Michael, me low, Lord Michael, Lord Michael, wherever I go. I am in the road heading here, I am in the road heading here, I am in the road heading here. Lord Michael, me for, Lord Michael, behind, Lord Michael to the right, Lord Michael to the left, Lord Michael above, Lord Michael, me low, Lord Michael, Lord Michael, wherever I go. I am in the road heading here, I am in the road heading here, I am in the road heading here. Lord Michael, me for, Lord Michael, behind, Lord Michael to the right, Lord Michael to the left, Lord Michael above, Lord Michael, Lord Michael, wherever I go. I am in the road heading. Lord Michael, before, Lord Michael, behind, Lord Michael, the right, Lord Michael, the left, Lord Michael, above, Lord Michael, above, Lord Michael, above, Michael, wherever I go. I am in the red heading here, I am in the red heading here, I am in the red heading here. Beloved seven mighty archangels in the victory of the light, come forth now for the deliverance of all people, for the deliverance of the nations, for the cutting free of America from all conspiracy known or unknown, all schism in the psyche, item in the binding of the very cause and core of the death cult, item in the binding of the core of pornography and rock and all types of drug experience, clouding the mind from receiving the divine incarnation of the living word. Blaze the full power of the seven mighty archangels in this hour. In the name of the mighty I Am Presence, we summon the hosts of the Lord and the legions of light for the deliverance of the souls of this people and the people of every nation. Beloved Archangel Uriel, come forth now in the name of Jesus and cut us free now and forever to serve the living God. Amen.
Thank you.
archangel Uriel and legions of peace. Hail, archangel Uriel and legions of peace. Hail, archangel Uriel and legions of peace. Hail, archangel Uriel and legions of peace. We greet thee in the name of the living God. We greet thee, O mighty archangel, in the name of the Son, Jesus Christ. Angels of the living fire, angels of the living light, now minister unto the evolutions of earth. In God's holy name, I am that I am. We pray this day that the mighty flame of cosmic Christ's peace consume the cause and core of war, the record, the memory of all battles and bloodshed, engendering and reactivating war in the human psyche. We demand the binding of the godless and the fallen angels this day who foment war to manipulate mankind, setting brother against brother. We demand the angels of the Lord and the armies of heaven camped on the hillsides of the world. Go to, bind the evil one. Bind the oppressors of my people. Set the captives free in the name I am that I am. We call forth God's judgment through his Son upon those individuals known or unknown, east and west, in every nation, who contemplate and plot the destruction of any part of life, whether small or great, who contemplate the conquest of other people's ground and nations and territory and their very souls. We call to Almighty God, where else shall we go, O God, but to thy refuge? For thou alone canst resolve the affairs of men. Therefore come to the earth by the free will ordained in our very divine spark. We implore thee, O God, send thy legions of light this day, and let miracles of peace flood the earth, and let the implements of destructivity be bound and rendered inactive, and let the light of the Son of God prevail. Therefore, in the name of Jesus, we invoke the judgment. In the name of the I Am That I Am, I invoke the electronic presence of Jesus Christ. They shall not pass, they shall not pass, they shall not pass. By the authority of the cosmic cross of white fire, it shall be that all that is directed against the Christ within me, within the Holy Innocent, within our beloved messengers, within every son and daughter of God, is now turned back by the authority of Alpha and Omega, by the authority of my Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, by the authority of Saint Germain. I am that I am within the center of this temple, and I declare in the fullness of the entire spirit of the great white brotherhood that those who then practice the black arts against the children of the light are now found the votes to the Lord, do now receive the judgment of the Lord Christ within me, within Jesus, and within every ascended master. Do now receive in the full return, multiplied by the energy of the cosmic Christ, of their nefarious deeds which they have practiced since the very incarnation of the Word. Lo, I am a son of God. Lo, I am a flame of God. Lo, I stand upon the rock of the living Word, and I declare with Jesus, the living Son of God, they shall not pass, they shall not pass, they shall not pass. Elohim, Elohim, Elohim. In the name of Almighty God, we demand the judgment in this hour of all individuals known or unknown, the godless and the fallen angels in embodiment, who have declared war against humanity through the manipulation of their sacred labor, their professions, their education, their money, their economy, to the very depth of their striving and their soul's evolution. We demand the binding and the judgment of all forces, known or unknown, anywhere on planet Earth or outside this planetary body, interfering with the spiritual evolution of the race, the divine life and liberty and pursuit of happiness of all people everywhere. Angels of the Lord's host, descend. O living Christ Jesus, come now into manifestation in our hearts and send forth thy mighty light rays for those who are the molesters and the abusers of the light of our children, our youth, and all people everywhere. We demand the binding of the arch fiends that have returned as the destroyers, even from the ancient days of Atlantis, those who are perpetrating their evil deeds against humanity in the form of all manner of destruction. We call upon God's judgment this day for the binding of all unreality, the binding of all their illusion and strong delusion they have spread abroad in the earth. And let there be the victory of Almighty God this day through all of his people on earth. And therefore we say, in the name of the I Am That I Am, I invoke the electronic presence of Jesus Christ. They shall not pass, they shall not pass, they shall not pass. The cosmic cross of white fire, it shall be that all that is directed against the Christ within me, within the Holy Innocent, within our beloved messenger, and within every son and daughter of God, is now turned back by the authority of Alpha and Omega, by the authority of my Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, by the authority of Saint Germain. I am that I am within the midst of the temple, and I declare in the fullness of the entire spirit of the great white brotherhood, that those who then practice the black arts against the criminal light are now bound by the host of the Lord, do now receive the judgment of the Lord Christ within me, within Jesus, and within every ascended master. Do now receive then the full return, modified by the energy of the cosmic Christ, of their various deeds which they have practiced since the very incarnation of the Word. Lo, I am the Son of God. Lo, I am the flame of God. Lo, I stand upon the rocks of the living Word, and I declare with Jesus the living Son of God, they shall not pass, they shall not pass, they shall not pass. Elohim, Elohim, Elohim. In the name of the I Am That I Am, I invoke the electronic presence of Jesus Christ. They shall not pass, they shall not pass, they shall not pass. By the authority of the cosmic cross of white fire, it shall be that all that is directed against the Christ within me, within the Holy Innocent, within our beloved messenger, within every son and daughter of God, is now turned back by the authority of Alpha and Omega, by the authority of my Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, by the authority of Saint Germain. I am that I am within the center of this temple, and I declare the fullness of the entire spirit of the great white brotherhood, that those who then practice the black arts against the criminal light are now found by the host of the Lord, do now receive the judgment of the Lord Christ within me, within Jesus, within every ascended master. Do now receive then the full return, modified by the energy of the cosmic Christ, of their various deeds which they have practiced since the very incarnation of the Word. Lo, I am the Son of God. Lo, I am the flame of God. Lo, I stand upon the rock of the living Word, and I declare with Jesus the living Son of God, they shall not pass, they shall not pass, they shall not pass. Elohim, Elohim, Elohim.
Thank you. We are living in the conclusion of the Piscean Age, the 2,000-year dispensation given to us by God through his Son, Jesus Christ, implemented by many other saints. The lessons we are intended to learn in this 2,000-year period and all of humanity are contained in the life and mission and experience and teachings of Jesus Christ. Unfortunately, all of these have not been preserved and recorded. Thus, he has promised to send us, and he has sent us, the Comforter, the Holy Spirit, who would lead us into all truth and bring those things to our remembrance which he has taught our souls through the ages. By the Holy Spirit, we contact the heart of Jesus, and as disciples of Jesus, we desire to put on the mantle of his love, his sacred fire, his courage, his boldness to deal with injustice and those bent on the destruction of the holy innocents, whether by the sword of Herod or whether by the slow death of the taking of the very vitals of life and the living of life to its fullness in freedom. Thus, there are those who perform heinous crimes that are sudden and violent, and then there is the massive enslavement of a people to their own unreality, the illusions of the world, or various systems. At the conclusion of the Piscean Age, it is the expectancy that the evolutions of the planet should have integrated with the living Christ of Jesus and actually become like him. He is our elder brother as well as our Savior. He is the one who takes us by the hand and shows us how to do what he did, never making of himself an idol or an unreachable star, but rather the example, saying that the same God that is in me is in you. One of the greatest tools we have been given to accelerate the path of individual Christhood, which is the meaning of discipleship, discipline for the internalization of Christ consciousness with us. That tool is the science of the spoken word taught by God to the ancient prophets. Command ye me. The science of the spoken word is what we are exercising and what the ancient priests of all faiths and religions, as well as followers, have exercised in the mantra, in the chant, in the prayer, in the Hail Mary. The use of the power center, which you can feel pulsating right at the base of the neck, is the authority of the creative word. That power descends not of yourself, for I of mine own self can do nothing. It is the Father in me which doeth the work. That Father has manifested his presence to you in the I am that I am, the cloud of the Shekinah glory that is the source of life to each individual life stream. God has placed his presence with us. It's like a replica. There is one God, but each of us moves in the presence of that God. It appears as though we are many because we are in time and space, and that is necessary for our state of evolution. But the I am presence of all of us is the one God, the one I am that I am, who, because he is infinite, has the ability to focalize himself wherever I am. When I say wherever I am, I'm saying wherever the divine spark of the divinity is. There I choose to be. I choose to be one in the name I am, in the power of the I am, in the love of the I am, and in the wisdom of the I am. And I choose this lawfully because God has ordained it for me and for you, for we are also his offspring. We can note in a human lineage that the offspring bear resemblance to their parents. We should expect that, spiritually speaking, we resemble our God, for we are made in his image and likeness. What parent would withhold any good thing or inheritance or any accomplishment from his children? So God does not withhold himself from us, and this is one of the demonstrations of Jesus Christ. In the end of his mission, he said, all power is given unto me in heaven and in earth. This was spoken at the conclusion of his mission, which explains the path of discipleship as a path of initiation. When we encounter adversity, it is the way we handle it that makes of us victors or the defeated ones. Life is a great schoolroom. Day by day we meet the challenges whereby we can increase our own sense of integrity, because we know we can deal in balance with any condition that comes our way. It's wonderful to live on earth and understand oneself as a student of the great law of life, as a student of the great lights of history, east and west, loving them, understanding them, observing how they went through trial and tribulation, how they conquered, the profound humility that we discover in the greatest of all men and women is something to make our hearts also soften, in the sense that we are only instruments and that God has so deigned to enable us to receive that power when we use that power only for the blessing and the good of others. We have a great responsibility when we understand the sacred name of God I Am does release that power. And therefore, somewhere along the line of the studying of the teachings of the ascended masters, we are given that temptation to use the power of God to in some way hurt or defeat our enemies, or to get even, or to take revenge. That temptation is a very serious one. And at that point, we decide our fate and our relationship with God. The decision must be to respect the word of the Lord who said, "Vengeance is mine, I will repay." Now that delivers all of us from all of the problems of getting even or taking justice into our own hands or fighting some kind of a war or engaging in controversy or argument or whatever. We are sons of the great central sun. We are intended to be instruments of an outpouring of light and blessing and love that holds the balance in the earth, that delivers wisdom and comfort and kindness. This does not mean that we allow ourselves to be trampled upon by others' misuses of the light. This is why we reverse the tide, or this is why we give the judgment call. But it is always with the understanding that the Holy Christ Self, the higher consciousness, the real self of us, always holds the focal point of mediating the call. So we do not have preconceived notions of this one is right or wrong. Rather, we attempt to discriminate right action and wrong action and to deliver the individual from the ignorance or the folly of a limited or a wrong choice, but always turning over to God the adjudication of the matter. Now, the judgment call we have just given is the fulfillment of the law of karma, accelerated by our heart fire, giving to God the authority of that judgment. Jesus was a great example of this teaching. He said, "If any man believe not what I say and what I speak, I judge him not." Isn't that wonderful? We don't have to be responsible for who accepts or rejects what we might do or what we might say, or whether there is a judgment when the Holy Spirit delivers to us a message of great life. In other words, we don't have to be responsible for the world's reaction. If we are true to ourselves and true to God, and we have come as close as we are capable of perceiving that God, and we are honest and sincere, we know that as we pursue that level of truth, that truth itself will reveal to us the lingering error and limitation of our conception. God's laws are immutable and perfect, but we are ever evolving toward a greater apprehension of that perfection. And no one on the planet has any particular ordainment of declaring what that perfection is. No one has a prior right to it to say, "I am the one to declare what it is." But it is each individual's responsibility to pursue the light through prayer and service, trial and error, testing what one believes in by what works in the practical sense of fulfilling God's laws and helping people. So Jesus said, "I judge him not. There is one that will judge him, and that is the Word." The Word as the Logos. In the beginning was the Word. Without the Word was not anything made that was made. All things were made by him. The Word then is the power of the Godhead to create. It is an intense sacred fire, and it is the nucleus of each one's Christhood. We could not create a thing. We couldn't bake a pie or build a house or sew a piece of clothing or do our daily job if we didn't have the power to create. We have a spark of the Logos within us. And if we did not, free will would be of little use, because free will is to be exercised in our experiments of creation. Now God has set a trinity in motion, and that trinity governs our experiments in free will on earth. The Father is the lawgiver, the divine will. The law of Moses came from the principle and person of the Father. The law itself is the governing of atoms and cells and chemistry and physics, and the way everything works in the physical universe. The law also has to do with our karma. and the sending out of light and the return of light, the sending out of love and love returns, the sending out of hatred and hatred returns. All of the laws governing our existence in matter come from the Father. The power to create according to those laws and the freedom to create comes from the Son, represented in your Holy Christ self. Now, what happens when we miscreate? Children know what happens. They mold the clay with their hands. If they don't like what they have created, they put it back into a big ball and roll it up again and start all over. So the power of the Holy Spirit is the power to consume, to transmute, to change. If we hold in our hand our best efforts, but it is not the highest manifestation, the power of the Holy Spirit then adds the love and the fire of God to enable ourselves to transcend ourselves and the creation itself to be perfected. We are all in the process of self-perfectionment. As we behold a higher image and we desire to put it on, we see a new awareness of Christ and we say, well, I am made in the image and likeness of God, and that image is Christ, and I am destined to be like him. And now I perceive more of his love. I want to be like that. That's the Holy Spirit. That's your authority by free will to create and to use the power of the Holy Spirit to change. Change is the action of God's miracles. It's an action of the seventh ray. The Holy Spirit, known as Shiva in the East, is called the destroyer, the creator, the preserver, the destroyer, the Hindu Trinity. That destruction means the breaking of the matrix of evil. But we understand that with the flame of the Holy Spirit, this breaking of the old order does not have to occur by cataclysm, but can come forth by the divine transmutation of God. Now, the judgment that is executed by the Son, of which we are speaking, is the discrimination of the universal Christ in all of us. But yet that which exists independently of us and does in truth fulfill the judgment. When we make the call, God then through the Son enacts the judgment. The thing I wanted to point out about the judgment call is that it deals with those who for millions of years have taken free will, chosen the left-handed path, once they understood the science of the Word of God, and extracting his power by the mysteries and secrets of his laws. They have chosen to use that light for the destruction of God's children, the destruction of every noble effort, every good cause, whatever would lead to the eternality and the immortality of the race and the people. Now, there are people on earth dedicated to no good purpose. And it is not simply an idling of the mind, it is a dedication that has gone on for thousands of years. Sometimes it is subconscious, sometimes it does not come to the fore except when in the confrontation of the great light. Those who have some of the greatest light among us today are the newborn babies, the little children that come from heaven, those who re-embody, who have not been stained or tainted by the world, and whose very presence in the physical octave is the presence of God's love. And it is a great power to hold the balance of nations. This is why all people have felt blessed when they have been given the gift of children to all ages. Thus often, the wicked are enraged by the presence of those who are called the holy innocents, because their light stops them. And they are surrounded by angels, the children are. And thus, you see the campaign in abortion itself at another level, entirely apart from women's rights, entirely apart from the freedom of choice. At a baser level, we see that the incoming children in this age, in the conclusion of the Piscean age, are here to take up the calling and the role of implementing the next 2,000-year cycle, which is called the Age of Aquarius, whose hierarch is our beloved Saint Germain, who was embodied as Joseph, who fulfilled the role of father to Jesus and husband to Mary. We understand then that these tendencies in the subconscious nature of people do not come out except in the divine encounter and the confrontation with some form of God's presence, whether in children, whether in the cause that is just, whether in someone who takes a stand for the highest. We realize then that as we are sons of God in the earth, and that means S-U-N, we are sons of God, we are lights of God present in the earth, that we have an integrity and an individuality to maintain, and that the judgment call, or the reversing of the tide, is the use of the science of the spoken word to send back to the source, to the creator. We call ourselves co-creators with God because we've been given the divine spark and the free will and the presence of Christ to create. Those who miscreate and send hatred, which can cause illness, sickness, death, psychic murder, and so forth, must receive their own energy back because they are the owners of that energy. It belongs to them. They are creators of destruction. One day, the vast cycles of the law of karma will surely return that energy, that momentum, to the doorstep of the sender. Every word you speak, every kind of feeling you send forth, is stamped with the imprint of your particular identity. And therefore, by the magnet itself, it returns to your doorstep. So we see that we are either responsible for everything in our life because we have created it, or we are responsible for calamity in our life because we have accepted it. We have made ourselves a doormat for a world consciousness, a mass consciousness that objects to change and to light. So in the case of our own free will expression and our own creation, by enlightenment, by self-discipline, by willpower, by the power of God we invoke, we can change and become only constructive individuals in thought and word and deed. On the path of constructivism, we pursue the masters as our teachers, as giving us an understanding of the day-by-day challenges. Next, we must consider then what to do when those arrows of outrageous fortune pierce the aura and attempt to interfere with our defense of world freedom, the causes we espouse. I was talking to someone the other day, not connected with this organization, who was quite an interesting person. And she was telling me about her father, who was in a business with a partner. And one day his whole body became covered with boils and sores. It was a condition that no doctor could treat. They could not get rid of it. They could not diagnose it. And there it was. So after all means had been pursued, her father quietly said, speaking to these sores and boils, "You turn around and go back exactly where you came from." He was a very wise man. This man happened to be of the Jewish faith. Well, the very next day, his partner in business was covered with the boils and sores, and he was free. He didn't have them anymore. They went back where they came from. Now, what was the problem in the consciousness of this partner? He was extremely jealous of her father. Jealousy is a very negative trait. You may not know you have it. So sometime or another, I think we've all wished we could have something that someone else had. And of course, the great teaching that always heals envy and jealousy is that whatever anyone else has attained, you can attain because the same fire of God is in you. So why worry about it? Rejoice when someone else has good in his life and say, I have the same Father, I have the same universal Christ with me, and I too can do all things through Christ, which strengtheneth me. And we have the joy ourselves of conquering, of becoming educated, of gaining the victory over ourselves as we see the handicapped do and become champions in sports and otherwise. And so when we win for ourselves, we have that sense of integrity, a certain sense of presence, a sense that we tried, we made it, we discovered what were our inner resources. When we thought we couldn't go on, the strength of God descended upon us. And we exceeded ourselves. We proved that we could do more than we thought we could do when we joined hands with the infinite. So jealousy is a totally unnecessary vice. Everyone should get rid of it because jealousy prevents illumination. Jealousy holds a focus around the person who has it of ignorance, density, absence of real mental sharpness, because the jealousy actually eats you alive. You can't really focus and attune with God. So that's one thing that ought to be easy to get rid of because it is so harmful. And who wants to keep anything that is harmful? So let's all put it into the flame right now, okay? That's a real good thing to get rid of. I'm going to take the violet flame to consume it. Now remember, the thing I'm pointing out to you is the law of God's justice and his judgment. That particular example about the man and the boils, what does it point to? As long as he ignored the law of God and didn't demand that this be gone, it sat upon him because someone was exercising his will. A prior will of envy and jealousy focused on the man transmitted that hatred, and it condensed physically as boils and sores. Now, if we allow this temple, which we have as a gift from God, we only get one per lifetime, one temple. It's ours to use. It's our vehicle to serve the living God. It belongs to him. We didn't make it. God made this temple and said, this is my house. Keep it clean, and I will dwell in that temple with you. So we've only got one. Now, if this is God's temple, how can we allow it to become the doormat of other people's criticism or gossip or dislike or this, that, or the next thing? You know, Mark Prophet gave some very homely advice. I love to listen to it. He says, you know, you can't expect everybody to like you. You can't expect everybody to agree with what you say. You can't expect everybody to be for you. So don't try and change people. Don't expect it. Don't wait for the world to acclaim you. Just do your thing. Just be who you are and do your highest and your best. And be willing to take the consequences of misunderstanding or whatever they may be. Deal in love, but be true to yourself and your highest self, which is God. So here we are. We live in a world where people with undisciplined minds can have negative thoughts very easily. The point is, as a son of God, you have a right not to allow any of that to coalesce in your aura, to prevent you from fulfilling your divine mission. Doubts, uncertainties, limitations, it can't be done. I mean, you can talk yourself right out of your reason for being and think it's your own mind when actually there is a general weight of world consciousness of the denial of the living Christ in every one of the sons and daughters of God. So if you let the mass consciousness weigh you down in molasses, you can't get anything done. It's really simple. You're becoming a pacifist in the spiritual sense. You're letting it sit on you, and you're letting yourself become a non-effective person without spine, and you're not getting your job done. I believe and I know that every single one of you was told by angels of light, ascended masters, lords of karma, when you took embodiment, exactly what you must accomplish for good, for the upliftment of humanity, the settling of old accounts with people where there is karma. Karma comes into play in many times in personal relations, father, mother, brother, sister, husband, wife, and children, business partners. Some of the worst of ourselves comes out in those relationships, and hopefully the best. And so we learn to see the worst in ourselves by finding it in someone else, and that's how karma works, until we both transcend together and are freed and liberated. Now, if you have a divine plan, and you don't know what it is and you're not fulfilling it, you see there is a subtle, sometimes aggressive, and sometimes a passive energy that simply clouds the issue, has you in perpetual confusion, has you putting your attention into 5 or 10 or 25 different projects, accomplishing none of them. And when you are through, when you have served your lifespan and you go back to the octaves of infinite light and you converse with your teachers and you review this lifetime, you are going to have to report. You gave me this assignment 90 years ago, 50 years ago. This is what I have done. It'll all be there. The record will be there. The motion picture will play of that life, the choices you've made. Now, will you regret not having fought the good fight and defeated all these foes and fears? Or will you really be able to say, I did the most and the best that I could for God? Not only did I try, lots of people say I tried. It's not trying, it's succeeding. Don't tell me you're going to go out and try. Tell me you're going to go out and succeed. It's a big difference. The apostles spoke to us as the carnal mind being enmity with Christ, and that those who are the followers of Christ will find that they cannot serve God and mammon, and the world as a world consciousness, as the antithesis of the spiritual consciousness, will be a negative factor, an opposition to that light. It's the nature of time and space. It's the nature of the octave we live in. We don't subscribe that this particular force is a boogeyman peeking out behind the nearest shadow of a tree, but rather the condition, the vibratory condition of the planet itself. We have descended to this level because this is the plane where we made our karma. This is where we've sown in many past lives. This is where we must reap. If we don't like what we see, we can change it because God gave us the spoken word. And if we'd rather be living in a nicer place where there's no war and there's peace and there's beautiful music and no problems, we have to create that place. We have to create that place where we are and be so much the embodiment of that harmony and love and maintain it lifetime after lifetime that finally God calls us to that place where he lives and the angels live, that is, as the golden age consciousness. Mankind would not be dreaming of golden ages and utopias if they didn't exist somewhere. So to complain and to gripe and to point the finger and to say, oh, this is terrible and the world is terrible and everything's bad, is really a very negative state to be in, because we have the power of God to change. And if we don't get in there and change it, we really should not be griping about it. Because the only person that can change what you see is you. And if you look to someone else to do it, you've already become an idolater. You're going to let somebody else do it, so you've made them either your Savior, or you've abdicated your mission and said, well, let someone else do that. But you see, there isn't someone else. In the divine reality, there's only one great self, and that is God. And we're all part of that great self, and we all have a very important role to play. The name of the church you belong to, the system of religion you subscribe to, is immaterial. The only thing that counts is action. If your religion makes you a better person, fine. If it doesn't, you ought to be seeking a higher understanding. Now, we're talking about judgment, and we're talking about keeping the integrity of God where God has given us to be, where He has placed His I am. When you take the consequences of the defense of the flame of freedom in your heart as the flame of God, you start to have to defend your family, your territory, your nation, your economy, your government. Because ultimately, if these things do not reflect God's freedom, one day, sooner or later, they will come to challenge and encroach upon that particular flame in your heart. The attacks of those who are in psychiatric wards, in Soviet hospitals, is really the attack on the light and the integrity of the Christ dwelling in the temple, dwelling with the soul. That is what is hated. That is the point of world hatred, devil hatred. I don't call it human hatred because I don't think humanity has the capacity for the hatred that we see manifest in embodied devils who can torment and torture life with such calculations of cruelty. Understanding this equation, we realize what is the great gift that Saint Germain has given to us, as he is the ascended master who sponsored the nation, the United States of America. He sponsored the pilgrims. He sponsored the discovery of the New World in his embodiment as Christopher Columbus. He sponsored this land as a place where freedom as a flame must be defended at all costs. And those who defend it must be willing to pay the price in life, because if they do not do so, they will pay the price in death. America is a unique experiment in liberty sponsored by the Ascended Masters through Saint Germain. She could never have become what she has become without divine intercession. And God intercedes on earth through his emissaries, just like he intercedes with one another through us. Someone needs help, you give it. You don't expect a vapory spirit to come into the room and do it. You do it. You are God's representative, and God has representatives in all octaves and planes of being. And if this were the ultimate and the last place to be, who would want it? We're all living because we know there's something better to come. But we have to make this place as good as we can make it. Now, if your child needs something, you don't sit back and call to an angel to do it. You do it. In this octave, you're God's instrument. God has other instruments, ascended masters and angels, and they intercede and help us. They add to our project. They give strength. They give power. They give training. They give commands. They tell us what to do to avoid danger, as they warned Saint Germain as Joseph to take Mary and Jesus and flee into Egypt. If it wasn't for Saint Germain, the boy Jesus may have never survived to fulfill his mission. God has intercessors, and Saint Germain ask God to use him to bring freedom back to this dark star. And he's been working at it for a long, long time. And I'm going to tell you about all of his embodiments in just a moment, but I want to go back to the making of the call for our surrender of our human consciousness of envy and jealousy, because I think it's a gift to Saint Germain to get rid of some of this substance so he can use us and we can be better instruments. Now, just as we don't allow encroachment upon our flame by someone else's human consciousness, so we don't allow our own human consciousness to encroach. So we start with ourselves. We cast the mote out of our own eye so we can see clearly to discriminate good and evil on earth. Now listen to my prayer, and if you agree with it, then let it register in your heart. If you do not agree, you need not join me. Our Heavenly Father, we are grateful to gather in this tent with thy people on earth. We are grateful to offer our sacrifice in the wilderness, as was done of old, and we understand that the most important sacrifice we can make is to surrender those states of mind and heart that are not acceptable unto thee, that will not provide the acceptable offering, not the acceptable offering of Abel, but the unacceptable offering of Cain. We therefore surrender our envy, our jealousy, our pride and ambition, and we demand that these momentums of consciousness, now still in our auras as vibration, be cast into the violet flame, the all-consuming power of the Holy Ghost, who shall take now the cause, effect, record, and memory of our envy and jealousy toward any part of life which we have ever manifested in all previous embodiments and incarnations. We ask that the holy angels of the violet flame and all saints who serve the violet flame shall come to us in this hour and shall take from us those records as much as the great law will allow, leaving only that which is necessary for our own self-mastery and edification. Our Father, we call upon the law of forgiveness for any consciousness of envy or jealousy we have ever felt toward any part of life, and especially which has then triggered actions of unkindness or hatred. Beloved Father, beloved Son, beloved Holy Spirit, beloved Mother, come into these temples now. Be the all-consuming sacred fire. Let the violet flame flow through our hearts, through the crown chakra, the third eye, the throat, the solar plexus, seat of the soul, and base of the spine. Blaze the light through, blaze the light through, blaze the light through. We call upon the law of forgiveness, and we also forgive all others who have ever wronged us. And in my Christ spirit of forgiveness, we now invoke the violet flame for the freedom of our soul, the freedom of our God in this temple, and the freedom of all life toward whom we have directed any damaging thoughts or feelings or acts. In the name of the Holy Spirit, we pray. heart friends of the ages, I come this day to pay tribute to the Knight Commander Saint Germain. I come to give homage to the Goddess of Liberty, who gave me the strength to endure through my service as George Washington and as your own messenger, Godfrey. Beloved ones of freedom, it is a joy and a privilege to be with pilgrims and pioneers from many nations who have gathered in the heart of this inner retreat and who have had the vision to secure a place and a place prepared at that for any and all eventualities of the spirit and of matter. Delicate flowers of the heart of Portia and strong minute men and women of Saint Germain, children of purity and mature souls who are wise for your sojourn on earth in this life, I welcome you all in the name of the great I Am, and I send my love to every life stream upon earth who in this hour and lifetime has devoted the heart to the mighty I Am presence, to the power of God presence with you, and to the duty of the service of that one. The mighty I Am presence is the way to your victory, its revelation unto me by the Master Saint Germain was the key to my victory. Beloved ones, the retreats were opened for me. The doors were unlocked, and I entered that I might bear witness and testimony unto the octaves of light and the continuing opportunity in Earth Schoolroom for you to study and to learn and to overcome. I will tell you that I also had things to overcome in my life. And it was with the understanding of my mighty I Am presence and the great law of the I Am that I was able to surmount not only my own karma, but all difficulties which beset my path. Believe me, beloved heart, when you know the law and you know the way and you know when you call to your mighty I Am presence, the call compels the answer. You have a certain strength and a determination and an inner knowledge as to where to turn in time of trouble. Thus it was the Archangel Michael who protected me and beloved Lotus, our entire family and movement. Beloved ones, my taking leave of this octave, as it were in an untimely manner, but nevertheless compelled by God, did leave the I Am movement in a situation of vulnerability. I pray that you understand that the great strength and the reinforcement of this activity by the Ascended Masters and the Chelas is for the mighty purpose of fulfilling that work left undone and that had to be fulfilled in the latter part of this century. And this was due to the fact of the non-response of those who should have come in to the mighty power of the decree work, and also to the opposition of the black magicians, the dark ones who determined to hold back the full expression of the light to those who remain. Beloved hearts of living flame, the centuries and the decades move on. The one messenger of God and the only messenger is the eternal Christ. And that eternal Christ will place his mantle upon the one called by God in any or every age, in time of calamity or epidemic or plague or cataclysm, to bring to the people the comfort and the joy of the I Am Presence and the knowledge thereof. Thus you see, the true messenger of God is one and is not defined by any one individual who may be empowered thereby. But the messenger of God is a holy office, and it is the office of your own Christ self. Thus your Christ self does deliver to you the emanations of the mind of God, and is indeed your higher mental body, or your higher consciousness, as you say. Thus as you walk the earth, you become the soul messenger of your own higher mental body, and you are intended to be the instrument of the Word of God to give that compassion and comfort to life. The only true comfort there can be must be laid upon the foundation of your mighty I Am Presence, the knowledge of its supreme power in your life, your conviction that is absolute and unwavering, that out of the heart of your mighty I Am Presence will one day descend the gift of your own ascension, which you will earn, and yet which God will give to you by His grace. Beloved ones, this is the path. Walk ye in it, for all else is illusion, and all else is of the human, which has no power and no reality. And you must take this opportunity in the mountains to dwell upon your presence, to meditate upon your presence, and to give the call to your beloved I Am Presence, as it is written. Dear hearts of living flame, if you can develop the habit of placing your attention on your I Am Presence at 5 points in the day, equally separated, you will discover a new thrust, as it were, to your prayer wheel of life, and you will find your chakras beginning to turn and your sacred center is accelerating. You will find a new consciousness. Sometimes you are so involved in doing things, all of those things that are certainly necessary, and you have in the back of your mind that in a little while you will decree, in a little while you will meditate, and in the meantime, the substance accumulates. It becomes more and more dense. You deal with the mass consciousness. You become less effective, and yet, somehow, as though you were glued to it instead of God, you do not stop for those precious moments of communion. When you develop the habit of the five secret ray meditation, which I give you herewith, you will see the propelling power of God when your attention is upon Him. O my angels of the flame of God obedience, teach my beloved to listen to the promptings of the eternal Christ within. O voice of the One, speak to thy children, speak to the youth, speak to all people. O soul of light, daughter of God, Son of the Most High, hear me, I address you. Deceive not yourself, deceive not your mother or your heavenly father, but rather embrace the cosmic honor flame of God and find in the intensity of the light the fulfillment of all that you desire. Beloved hearts of living flame, you will never regret the riveting of your attention upon your God, nor will you regret your resistance to the devil who would tempt you into byways. You will never regret your obedience to God first, for God is a rewarder of those who cherish in love obedience to his commandments, which are set not to bind or limit you, my beloved ones, but rather for your exaltation, for your protection, and for your own ability to be the vortex of his expanding light. In the fullness of your God's presence is all that you desire, and you will never know how true this is until you go to the fount of the Godhead and realize how precious, how mystical, how profoundly powerful is the light of God that streams forth and elevates you above the morass of the lower consciousness and directs your attention to the fulfillment of all God happiness through all God obedience. I can assure you that though no outer person may police your habits and your goings and your comings, the angels of God watch over you, and they do weep when you close your door of opportunity by indulging in those things that you ought to set aside for the better and the higher way. Thus the angels are burdened when they see that in the desire for freedom and liberty, you can actually set aside the great law that has been your first love in the beginning and will one day be your first love in the ending. For you shall come full circle, but unless you retreat to the heart of God, and that quickly, you will find, my beloved, that you will go a wide circle of experience in Maya before you return to the Holy of Holies. And in that experience of the karma that comes upon you in place of divine opportunity, you will find that once on that roller coaster, you will then long for the day when you can once again be in the heart of Lanello, be in the heart of the mother. But when you take the road that leads on to another and another, you will find that the cycle must run its course. And when you return, you will find that the little pine tree is grown very, very high. And you will say, look at all of this. Look at these shining ones. Look at what they have become while I have gone out to make my way with my knapsack on my back over the highways and byways that are endless over the face of the earth. Thus, beloved ones, obedience is a shining light that enables you to enter in. I remember when Rex and Nada and Bob and Pearl were taken into the inner temple. What joy, what victory. I bring you the message of your own present ability to move with the immortal, to be a part of them, for you are also immortal here and now, as Saint Germain has told you. My beloved, understand then that you are being instructed even now at inner level. You are receiving the teaching for the molding of character, the shaping of your life, the divine design of your future, and what you are capable of giving to future generations by planning for your offspring, by planning for your own service to life in whatever field. This life is so beautiful when you stand at the threshold of opportunity. Make the most of it, beloved heart, For as the years turn, you realize that you cannot go back to the moment of eternal youth and opportunity that seems so easy now. Will not deny in future rounds when the challenge of karma and the planetary dweller and the defending of the community will be a responsibility on your shoulders. Now let the honeycomb, now let the angles of light, now let the hexagon and the octagon teach you of the power of 3 times 3, the power of the 6-pointed star, the power of the 8-fold energy field of the God Star, and the light of Surya with us in this nation. The legions of Archangel Michael and the legions of Sirius are behind the protection and the founding of America. If you could realize that home is the God Star, that you have come from a most wondrous place of light, and the grandest, most vast home. If you could realize that angels from the God Star to come and walk with you and comfort you in your loneliness. Be not lonely, precious heart. And remember that aloneness itself has an intrinsic virtue, for in the aloneness there is space to meet thy God. Space not cluttered by a clamor of voices making demands upon your life and light. Beloved heart, let God fill the vacuum and fear not to create it by the self-emptying process. For in the whiteness and the stillness of a winter's night at Valley Forge, it is as though infinity itself softly, softly steps in and fills the air with a quality not of the heaviness of the moisture, but of the power of the presence of God. God's presence as the permeation of the aura of that God Star spirit was a part of the victory of that war we fought in the spirit of freedom, led by the Eternal Mother in the person of the Goddess of Liberty. Oh, how she is and was and always shall be that comforter, the one who inspires patriots, defends America, holds the dream as the book of the law, will never let down her torch, will light your way and lead you into that perfect love for which your soul longs. How else can one fulfill love except in service to one's country, one's world, hand in hand with light bearers and family and souls that are so much a part of thy living heart? We were few in number, but we kept a flame. She placed it in our hearts. It warmed us when we had neither food nor clothing. Beloved one, that experience to me, that necessary, that holy, if you will, revolution, taught me how the individual can transcend himself his poor powers to function, his present meager potential, not once, but 10 and 20 times. How God, as the steely white fire of Serapis, can come through one's temple like the cold winds of winter passing through a lattice when no roses are in bloom. How the fire of God can come upon a soul and lead an army and keep them unto the end, even in the face of those who then, so soon, were the enemies of Christ in our nation's history. Ah, yes, there were many who were against the war, who would not provide the funds or the support. There are always those who can never, ever see the vision. They can never identify who is the enemy, who is the friend, and which way is up. Be not discouraged. The one predictable thing about them is that they always hang around. Well, beloved hearts, it sharpens one's mind and stills one's chattering teeth. For it is more the enemy at times than the love of God that keeps one alert. Thus there are yet battles to be fought and won. And the dearest one of all is your conquest of your own self-love that blinds you to the glory just beyond the turn in the road. Yes, I come. I come to do battle with that force in the self that prefers the self for many reasons, out of fear for one, and absence of vision of the mighty I Am Presence for another. It is most dangerous because it also causes you to give deference to your human will and set aside the divine when the reverse ought to be true. Thus you see, self-love is the greatest single obstacle to the path. Because it can never be seen, it is like a shadow. You turn around and you cannot see it. Yet it limits the divine expression and blinds you to the first order of the day and the duty to rise with the sun, to be the sun. When you greet the dawn at the horizon, you can climb with the sun to the zenith. But if you sleep till noon, it is mighty hard to go straight to the top of the sky. Thus, beloved one, the rising sun is the sign of your rising Christ consciousness. Greet the dawn with joy. Be industrious, build a new nation, a new culture, and a new world of the spirit. For this is a tangible manifestation of the city four square, this etheric retreat over the royal Teton Ranch. The etheric city of light becomes a god goal. And you will build your abode for shelter and be comfortable and even roomy. But one day you will step from your house on earth to your house in heaven. I tell you this not to hasten the day nor turn your attention to it. I have instead in mind a psychological reason, and that is to displace the thought form of approaching death with that of the approaching homing, going home to God's even as you ought to be certainly at home on earth. With all of the love of angels around you, though you do battle with the serpent, you can hardly keep from laughing in his face when he is so serious in his condemnation of you. It is good to be jovial in the face of the dead seriousness of the fallen one. And they are aghast that your laughter can blow them away like the gust of a strong wind of a beautiful spring morning in the Rockies. Oh, I have heights in the Rockies. I have climbed the mountains. I have been at Shasta. I have loved this earth and this soil, and I know the dreams that you dream. And they that are worthwhile ought to be fulfilled while there is time. But, beloved ones, the greatest dream you can dream is one of God, one of helping millions of souls find the mighty I Am presence, and then one day, stepping through that hatch, nevermore to descend again, except once again to commune and speak and admonish those who will follow in your footsteps. You know of me because I have written my experiences and preserved the writing and the law of Saint Germain. Let others know of you as numberless numbers of saints robed in white, who will be remembered for saving America and saving Earth for freedom's star. In the spirit of liberty I stand. She is one who will not leave you, nor shall I. I am come, your mentor, on the path of the Bodhisattva, on the path of the Buddha. I learned and won my freedom under Lanto, under Confucius, Gautama Buddha, and Maurya did not leave me alone until he was certain I had bound the very foe of my own life, which was in me, of course, for there are no other foes. Precious one, dearest heart, keep on striving and never fear to give something up of yourself for the cause of freedom, for the cause herself shall reward you openly, and your joy shall be full, and you shall seek no other. The twin flame, of love and light have released their causal bodies to you. From Maitreya Mountain, from the central sun, for by your harmony you have created a corridor to the very throne room of Helios and Vesta. The sustainment of harmony by the hour in the joy of song is one of the best means I know of fulfilling that law and mandate of harmony. With that attention on your presence, thus you have built the spiral within the corridor, and now, this evening, as you take your leave from your physical body temples, Helios and Vesta receive you with open arms of light and love, and vast wisdom of the sphere in their retreat in the temple of the sun. White angels with fiery shields and helmets and swords seraphim, legions of Justinian, of Uriel, Helios, and Vesta, my own bands and others, shall accompany you now into the heart of the sun known as this. Thus mighty Victory himself takes his name from the sun of this system, and it is to the Victory Retreat of Helios and Vesta that we go. I seal you in the honor of God as you give your allegiance to that honor. Sorry, the honor of God will never forsake you. Remember this, my